Module 2, Power BI Embedded Analytics. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, the course developer.
Hi, I'm Noam. I'm a product manager on the Power BI Embedded team.
In this video, we'll introduce embedded analytics, embed scenarios, and the development methodology that we use to structure the content in this course.
Power BI content can be embedded into apps to deliver stunning and fully interactive reports from Power BI directly into your web applications. This saves developers the time and expense of having to build controls from the ground up.
Power BI content can be embedded in any app. An iframe works in any modern browser control, and it relies on web standards of HTML5 and JavaScript. So it works in web applications, mobile applications, and even thick client applications. And you can seamlessly integrate Power BI content with the Power BI client APIs. We'll introduce those APIs in Module 5.
There are SDK resources that support different development platforms and languages. You can find official SDKs for .NET, .NET Core, JavaScript, and TypeScript. And you can also find samples for Node.js, Python, and Java.
Great, so let's now introduce you to the Power BI content types that can be embedded.
You can embed Power BI reports. Those can be embedded in view mode, edit mode, or even create mode to allow you to create a report in your web application. The reports can be embedded in fully interactive mode, even including the Q&A Explorer. You can also embed Power BI report visuals, that is, specific visuals from your reports. These visuals can only be embedded in view mode, but they can also be fully interactive. You can also embed a different kind of reports, which is paginated report. These reports can be embedded in view mode, and they are fully interactive with all of the capabilities of paginated reports.
In addition to reports, you can also embed dashboards. They're only available in view mode, and any interaction must be developed. And there's also support for real-time dashboards. There's also the ability to embed an individual tile from a dashboard. Again, it can be viewed without interaction, and real-time tiles are supported. And then lastly, the Q&A experience. It can be embedded to support interactive questions and responses, or support just a visual response only. So Noam, I think this would be a great time to introduce the Power BI Embedded Analytics Playground. Would you like to give us a quick tour?
Sure. So here I am in the Power BI Embedded Analytics Playground. You can see on your left the navigation pane. If I go to Explorer APIs, I can see it sample report loaded. This report is fully interactive. As you can see, I can select the filters and they're applied to my report. This can also be done programmatically in your code. On the left pane, you can explore all of the available APIs. If you click on one of the APIs, it will apply it to the report. Notice how the date slicer just changed the date range. Another thing you can see here is the Q&A, which is also fully interactive. You can either select one of the available questions, or you can even type a question of your own. So the Embedded Analytics Playground is a really great place to get familiar with Power BI Embedded. You can explore our APIs, see the available showcases, and also test this out with a sample report or with your own report. You'll see more of the playground in later videos of this course.
There are two distinctly different embed scenarios, for your organization and for your customers. In this course, we'll be emphasizing the for your customers scenario, but let's start by first describing the for your organization scenario.
The for your organization scenario is used for embedding for internal users. Your users will authenticate to Azure AD. This means that end users do require a Power BI license and that the authentication flow is interactive. And lastly, keep in mind that this is also known as user-owns data.
The for your customers scenario is for external users. You'll use your own authentication. There's no requirement for end user licenses to Power BI. There's non-interactive authentication flow when using service principal or master user, and we'll describe these shortly. And this one is also known as app owns data. Let's now introduce the development methodology. This methodology is just a framework that we're going to use to introduce theory and to present demonstrations during this course. So for now, let me give you a quick overview of what we'll be covering at each stage. At stage one, we'll be creating a Power BI workspace. At stage two, we're going to need some content, so we're going to create Power BI content and upload it to the workspace. This content will later be embedded in your app. Now we're ready to prepare the app development, and so we register an Azure AD application that will support acquiring access tokens. At stage four, we can then commence development, and so in our web project, we import some NuGet packages. We then add various app settings that will allow the app to communicate and authenticate with Azure AD and the Power BI service. An app setting will also store the workspace identifier. Then we add logic to embed Power BI content. This logic will include acquiring tokens. And once the embedding logic is written and tested, we can consider further enhancements to the user experience. For example, we could use the client APIs to integrate the Power BI content with the app, perhaps by adding interesting capabilities like client-side filtering. Lastly, at stage 8, we will consider data permissions, also known as row-level security, to allow different users to see different data from the datasets. Note that configuring data permissions shouldn't be a last consideration in your project. Security should be factored into your earliest design at planning time. Do note, the methodology is simply a guide for this course. It's used to help provide structure to the modules and lessons. So, for this first stage of the development methodology, you're going to need a Power BI workspace.
When you're embedding Power BI content for your customers, you need to have a workspace. This is where all your content will be held. This workspace can only be created and accessed by users with the Power BI Pro license. It can also be created by automation. Keep in mind that this should be a new workspace experience that's not bound to the Office 365 group. Only these new workspaces are supported by Service Principal, which is the recommended method. Lastly, each workspace is uniquely identified by its group ID. You will use this later on when embedding your content.
At stage two of the development methodology, you'll need some Power BI content. So Power BI content is added to workspaces. Any content can be embedded, be it datasets, reports, dashboards, and tiles, and each are uniquely identified by their resource ID. The Power BI REST API will allow enumerating resources to retrieve those IDs. Right, well, that concludes this video on introducing Power BI embedded analytics. In the next video, I'll be joined by Adam Saxton, who'll present a compelling example of an app that embeds Power BI reports.